and welcome to Young and Bummin' It. I'm here. My name is Owen. I'm the host, and I have some three spectacular guests for us today. And we're going to start off now with the one, the only, my youngest brother, Liam Harrington. Now we're going to go to my high school friend. He was born and raised in Shrewsbury, New Jersey. Now he resides in West Virginia, standing at 5'7", Eric Holly.
Thank you.
Welcome, Holly.
Thank you.
Welcome to the show. It's an honor to have you here.
Glad to be back.
It's great. I'm so happy. And now, last but not least, but our main attraction of the night, born and raised in Little Silver, New Jersey, now residing in Boulder, Colorado, my friend since fourth grade, Cody Platzer O'Malley.
Pleasure to be here, man.
Dude, I'm so souped you're back
in
Colorado.
Pleasure to be here.
I'm so happy. But we do have to make a shout out to our one fallen friend, Scott Silberstein. He was supposed to be our third guest. We had to bring in my little brother because in true Young and Bummin' It fashion, he actually went to detox on Sunday at 11:30, and he will be in rehab for the next month, but he will come back better and stronger than ever.
Yep.
So we'll pour a little out for our fallen friend, Sil. Thanks, guys.
Yep.
Now we're going to get to know our guests. We're going to start out with my little brother, Liam. He's 12 years old. He was born in Little Silver, right? Born and
yes,
raised in Little
was.
Silver. A little different than me. I was born in Keensburg, but it's okay. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your childhood? How great was your childhood?
Pretty great, I won't lie. I grew up a pretty good kid.
Pretty good kid?
If I do say so myself.
If you do say so?
I agree, yeah.
Well, do you have any, tell us something that you, like your most memorable moment from like when you were little. Do you have any good moments from when you were little?
Probably when I first broke something, maybe.
Well, when did you break something?
When I was like 5, I fell down the stairs and broke my eye socket.
Really?
Oh.
Yeah.
Do you have a lazy eye now?
No.
A little bit.
Sadly.
Your left one's a little lazy, but I think you broke the right one.
I don't know.
It's okay.
I don't really remember.
All right, and how about you, Mr. Holly, over there? I know you were born in Shrewsbury, right?
Yeah.
That's
didn't meet you till high school.
High school, I know. It's a good time.
Good times.
I think like one of the first times we hung out, like for real, was when I sliced your leg open at baseball with my cleats.
Yes. Mm. In baseball.
Yeah.
Had a good time.
Yeah, you slid into me.
I brought the
plate and you, yeah, you got a scar from
you
it. Can you show us?
Pants a little tight.
Oh, you
yeah,
got tight
they
pants
are.
On, you hipster.
Skinny jeans. Yeah.
Oh, God.
Cody was
angry. I can't believe that we hang out with this kid.
Right.
All right, now how about you, Cody? I know you should have some good stories.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I know you were born in Little Silver, right?
Yeah.
Raised by who?
Raised by Louise and Kevin.
Louise and Kevin?
Yep.
Are they good people, or like, how do you feel about
they're
them?
They're fairly decent parents. I like them.
You like them?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't really like your mom that much, but you know that.
That's all right.
But your dad, he's a good man.
He is a good man.
What does your dad call me? The O-Man! How you doing?
Yeah.
Mr. O, what's good?
Yeah.
He's a good guy.
Yeah.
I know that there's a good story about when you were a kid and you had an encounter with a hole of bees.
Oh, this
can
is
you,
true.
Can you inform us on that? Why don't you tell our audience
absolutely.
About that?
And I was a child, and I have a fairly large backyard. It's pretty narrow, but goes back like a solid good amount of feet.
Yards.
It's pretty far. It's big.
Yeah, it's probably a football field back
and,
there.
And my dad was out mowing the lawn, and then good kid fashion, I wanted to go hang out with him, and I just ran out, and I stepped on, I guess, an underground beehive, and just got bombarded by bees. Like, the whole thing came out.
Didn't they fly up in your pants and everything?
Yeah, exactly.
Got you good, right?
I got stung like 80 times, and since then, I've always hated bees. And
that's respectable, you know?
Yeah.
That was horrible. That's harsh.
Yeah, it was pretty devastating.
Yeah, things happen.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? At wildlife, you know? When you live back by the woods and creeks, you know,
yeah.
Those things come and get
you. These are a common thing.
Yeah. All right, let's move on to our next topic. I wanted to ask you guys, why did you guys choose, like, the bum lifestyle? Why don't we start with you, Cody, because you're the true bum here.
Yeah. I don't think you really choose it,
did
you
it
know?
Choose you?
It chose me.
It chose you, really?
Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of decisions I made that, you know, led me to this lifestyle. But
is it like thug life, but like bum life?
No, it's thug life is a little different. Like,
okay.
You do different things, but bum is just like, you don't do anything.
Oh.
You know?
Okay, so like, if you say where you were like gonna say you had some like a school homework to do or something like that, you know,
don't do it.
Papers?
No.
Okay, so what is something that you do? Like, I have a thing here that says we're gonna talk about activities next.
Activities.
So maybe you can tell us what bums do for their activities.
What bums do? Well, they often sleep in random places.
In random places, really?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, in general, bums should be friendly, you know? Like, our age bums, they should be pretty nice guys.
Like, good dudes?
Yeah, yeah.
Why should they be good dudes? Just because they got nothing, they're trying to mooch off people?
No. You don't mooch off people. Like, you gotta be friendly, because if you're not friendly, then you're not gonna get anywhere, you know?
I hear you, dude.
Yeah.
You catch a little more flies with honey and vinegar, right? That's the saying?
Yeah, I think so.
That's a good one. Change it to bums. Catch more bums with
money and cars.
How about you, Holly? What do you do? You're a graduated college bum. You've now graduated college. You've moved back home, and now you're just bumming at home, and you don't do anything.
Just living rent free.
Rent free. That's the way
hanging
to be.
Out, getting back to the
home cooked meals.
The high school bum days.
Hanging out surfing, at 7-Eleven. Hanging out at 7-Eleven.
Yeah.
Running
we used to do that all the time.
Cops and whatnot. Good old days.
Dude, did we not like grow up on the steps of 7-Eleven?
On the
steps of
7-Eleven. No, we just call 7-Eleven and be like, yo, who's at 7-Eleven?
Yeah.
Yo, what's up? It's Quinn. Quinn's at 7-Eleven. Let's go.
Yeah. That was awesome.
That was good.
The milk crates?
On the milk crates,
yeah. I think that they got rid of those because of us.
They did. They put an alert sign there.
Is the proper term.
Yeah. And they put a red box.
Yeah. So, like, Ben, you're a young bum. You're a replacement bum.
Yeah,
you're 12 years old, so you're just like always bumming it because you don't
living
have a job.
Yeah, I definitely
live
live rent free.
Your older brother pays for everything you do.
Pretty much, yes.
Yeah, you're welcome.
No problem.
Yeah. All right, my next topic here I have is gambling. How do bums feel about gambling? Let's start with Holly on this one. How do you feel about gambling?
Oh, yeah.
Let's put
you got a recent success story?
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
I was recently at the racetrack and accidentally raced on the wrong track and happened to win $100.
And did you share that with any of us?
Treated my friends to drinks that night.
No, you didn't.
No, you did not. We had to count up $5 and change it by a 12-pack.
Got them breakfast the next morning.
No, I didn't get no breakfast either. You bought him breakfast.
You were still bumming it in bed.
No, dude, I was working on this. I was writing out my note cards. Okay. My next topic I have here is neighbors.
Neighbors.
Not neighbors like neighbors that live next to you. Neighbors like Canada and Mexico, our neighboring countries. How do bums feel about Canada?
Well,
I think it's kind of hard to get
there. I think
Canada
is a pretty interesting place.
I figured bums would like it because it's free healthcare.
I think that Canada is like a downgraded America.
A downgraded America.
Only
so
because
what is Mexico, then?
They still like police on horses and stuff. Like,
oh,
bro, that's just not gonna work out.
Dude, we have police on horses. I see them all the time when we go to the city.
Yeah, that's a good point. All right, I take it back then.
Dude, our cops on horses wear helmets though.
Yeah, at least they're safe.
Yeah, it's because they have free healthcare. They don't care.
Yeah, exactly.
How about Mexico? How do you feel about Mexico, Liam? What do you know about Mexico?
I know that Mexico
besides the south of the United States.
Well, I know that Mexico is really hot.
Really?
Because
yeah.
All my friends go there because they're pretty rich. And,
do they ever take you?
No.
What kind of friends are they?
Bumming.
Yeah.
If you're
pretty
truly bumming
friends.
It, you got to get them to take you there.
Yeah. I'll try next time.
All right. Now, I have another one around here. How about social media? Do bums have social media? How do they feel about it? Like, do you guys have Facebooks?
Negatory. Yeah.
Holly, Facebook.
I do.
You do?
Yeah.
Don't use it much anymore.
All right. Let's move on from that. How about you? Do you have a Facebook?
Yes, I do, but
do.
I do not use it ever.
Why? Why do you have it then?
Because it's, I don't know, it's like.
Just fit in with the crowd?
Yeah, back then it's like you had a Facebook. Oh,
lame.
You're cool then.
Lame.
Yeah.
All right. How about, I know I'm pretty. You're a big fan of one of them, right? One of those things.
I do have a Twitter.
You have a Twitter.
Yeah.
Tell us
I mean,
about
I don't
that.
Do. I don't. I mean, I use it to follow like artists and musicians. You know, like I don't even.
Like,
I don't do anything. Yeah, exactly. But not.
Like
yeah, relatively like that.
Okay. And I have one here about global warming, but
that's an interesting topic.
That's an interesting topic, and we're gonna need a little bit more time for that because I know you got a good story for it.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So like, we'll wait a little. We'll come back to that one. I'll put my card over here. And we're going to go back to commercial break, so a word from our sponsors, and we'll be right back.
Sounds good.
It looks like a war zone down there. Sheriff, almost didn't recognize you in plain clothes.
Well, it's my day off. Should be a quiet weekend.
We have a situation.
We've got a cartel with heavy firepower headed towards the border. And there's a strong chance they're coming your way.
I've seen enough blood and death. I know what's coming. I'm not gonna let that guy come through our town without a fight.
Very nice.
How are you, Sheriff?
Old.
Go, go, go!
Bring everything you got.
Who the hell are you?
I'm the sheriff.
Wow, you're looking jacked. You've been working out?
I never know where the camera is, so I just go like this.
And welcome back. Are we back on?
Oh, okay, okay.
Welcome back to Young and Bummin' It with your host, me, Owen. And we were talking about global warming before we went back. But, so now we're going to talk right now, and our bum Cody has a good story about global warming.
Yeah, global warming.
You had to sleep in New York City.
What is it?
I don't think it has to do anything with global warming.
It was warm. Got much.
It was cold.
I was more shooting for the hurricanes.
Oh, there you go. Okay.
Told us about.
Yeah, that's a good point. All right.
Thanks.
So, if you're not aware, there was a hurricane recently. It's called Hurricane Sandy. And it was pretty devastating for, you know, the surrounding community, especially, like, our section of the Jersey Shore. And a lot of houses got destroyed. I was just recently at my cousin's house, and they told me that if you didn't do what the town said and raise your house 20 or 30 feet, then it's probably going to get destroyed next year, too, because there's apparently going to be another storm, like, just as bad as Sandy,
really?
If not worse, yeah.
Really? Is that proven fact?
Word of mouth.
Word of mouth.
Yeah.
But doesn't your cousin work at Seven Presidents Park?
Yeah, she does. That's a fact.
That's
yeah.
pretty good. You know, that's a pretty good source.
It's a pretty reliable source.
Yeah, it's a reliable source.
Yeah.
I think we need to go to story time now. I want to hear some good stories, all right?
All right.
I'll start one off with a good story.
All right.
Well, actually, I'm going to let you tell this story because this is the story with you in it about Hartshorn and the snowstorm. Okay. Me, you, Cody. I'll start off. Me,
oh,
Cody,
great
Liam,
story.
Snowstorm.
Yes. Hartshorn.
Blizzarding, can barely see your hand in front of your face. And we decided to go sledding at Hartshorn, a little free sledding. And we decided to bring my, at that point, maybe 8-year-old brother Liam. Snow is up to his waist.
If not his chest.
Maybe up to his chest.
He'd like jump into like the next spot.
And now tell us what happened.
Okay. So it's like, what would you say, 8 o'clock, 7 o'clock at night?
I don't know, it was dark.
Yeah, it was dark. So we go out there and we're like, all right, let's go sledding. And in case you didn't know, you know, it was a blizzard, of course.
A blizzard, you
know. Yeah.
Serious
so
blizzard, yeah.
So we find this hill that was kind of lame, but it was still a hill. And we were like, all right, let's do at least one hill before we get out of there. Because we had been there for like an hour walking around looking at stupid trees. So after we go down this hill like 3 times, it got not fun anymore. So we decided to leave. And of course we were lost and we didn't remember the way we came back.
How did you guys manage to get lost in Hartshorn though?
It's the woods and it was snowing.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Like, yeah.
Self-explanatory, I shouldn't ask that.
Yeah.
Okay.
But so instead of trying to walk back the way we came, which would have taken forever, we decided, hey, there's an open field here. This should lead somewhere. So we walked through this field for probably an hour
in the
freezing cold.
Easily.
Yes.
Yeah.
And yeah. And
we get halfway there, and Liam, 8 years old, turns to us and goes, are we ever going to get home?
But, you know, I was eight.
It was hilarious.
Yeah.
I was 8, though, I was scared.
I was like, you're going to get home. Shut up.
Shut up. We're fine.
I'm going to get you home.
All right. Now, seriously bumming it right here.
Yeah.
Cody has a great story of New York City and how to really be a bum in New York.
This pretty much characterized my bumming fashion. So this was 2 years ago, I think. And we were going to a concert on Governor's Island called Governor's Ball. And started the night out. You know, it was just me, Owen. No, I wasn't there. Yeah, it was not you. It was me, our fallen buddy Silb, and two other buddies. And, I mean, we finally get, nonetheless, we get from Penn Station to our buddy's house. It took like an hour and a half, 2 hours. And we get there. So, I mean, just to be straight up, we start drinking a lot. And we go to this concert. I mean, it was fun, I guess. From what
I
remember.
You don't really remember much?
Yeah,
of
it was a good time. You know, I had fun.
You think it was a good time.
But.
That's a good part.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. So we take this ferry back, and we're all in the group together. We get down to the subway, like, we're about to go back, and, like, everyone's like, yeah, get up. This is our stop. So, like, I'm, like, the last one to get up, and, like, I'm following everyone, and, like, I'm in front of the door, and the door closes. Like, subway closes. I'm just like, no, like, stop, like, wait for me.
No.
And, yeah, like, one of those ones was just like, no. And they all are, like, looking at me, and I'm just, like, looking at them leave, and I'm like, all right, I'll call them. Don't have my phone.
Typical.
Don't have my wallet.
Typical.
My shorts are empty. And I'm, like, I get off the next stop. I'm, like, dude, I'll just, like, start walking and try and find them. I don't know where to go. Like,
You're in New York City.
I don't know anything
about
the city.
People are always like, oh, the streets are numbered. You're fine. Like,
yeah,
when you're,
no.
When you don't know what you're, you
yeah,
can't find
it's
anything.
Not that easy.
Yeah, leave me alone.
Yeah, so essentially just woke up on the sidewalk. Had no idea what to do. Woke up in the morning. It's like 7 in the morning. I'm like,
and you woke up
like
on the
so,
streets of
yeah,
New York City.
And my collarbone is still messed up from that. Yeah, and just woke up, started walking around like, okay, what am I going to do?
How did you get home?
Yeah, went back to sleep on the sidewalk, woke back up,
so slept some
went
more.
To Penn Station. Just yeah, because I was, dude,
spot,
I just gave up. I was like,
spot.
I can't do anything right now.
I'm
going back
anything.
To sleep.
I'm a bum. I'm going to lay back down.
Yeah, so get to Penn Station miraculously, and I'm just like, I just would tell Lee, like, yo, I have, like, no money. Like, can I just get on this train right now? She's like, no.
Okay, that didn't work.
Like,
typical.
No,
that
you need
never
money.
Works.
And I was like,
all
right.
We always try that.
And just by a miracle of God, like, Matt Raybon is in Penn Station.
Who's Matt Raybon?
Matt Raybon is our buddy Eric Raybon's friend.
No,
his
it's brother.
His brother. Yeah, his brother. And he just, like, we ran into each other, and he ended up getting me home. And
that's
it was a rough good. Night, yeah.
Yeah,
it was
I
my
mean,
first,
you made it home?
It was my first bumming night, yeah.
Your first true bumming
true
night.
True bum, yeah.
You said mention your collarbones. I know our
oh yeah. Speaking
our
of collarbones,
our college grad bum, he's
or
got
lack
two
of collarbones.
Yeah, lack of collarbones. You got two bionic collarbones.
You show them the scars. Show them the scars.
No.
Why?
Come on, show your scars.
They're badass.
You want them to see your nipples?
They're not there.
Yeah, they are. Look at that thing.
Look at that.
Little snowboard accidents.
He's sensitive about his body.
Sensitive about his body?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh.
Very self-conscious.
That's okay. But I heard you had another story about a baseball game.
Oh, yeah, when I first met you guys.
First met us?
Yeah, around then.
Like
first
the
year.
First year we hung out with?
Tunnel story.
This is a good story.
We were on the same baseball team freshman year, and I didn't know them much. This was before my accident with the sliding. But we showed up at the game late, and like the coach asked me to find these two guys. And I could hear them.
I think Caleb was there. It was
Caleb.
Three of us.
Yeah.
I hear them yelling in a tunnel. So I go down there, and they're wandering around this sewage tunnel.
It's a good time.
Just, you can tell them what you did.
Do you want to tell us
oh, okay, yeah, yeah.
A little
all
more
right.
elaborate? Because he's horrible.
Yeah, terrible. we just, like, we found this old, like, sewage drain tunnel that was, like, right on our high school. And, like, in true bum fashion, we decided it'd be, like, fun to play in it. So,
we
got played this
the game early.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. We got there early, and
we
we're like,
the
dude, there's
like,
no
where's
one
everyone?
Here. Like, let's
like,
go
where's
walk
everyone?
Around.
Yeah.
And we started playing a game, like, who could throw a rock the farthest down the tunnel and go salvage it? And, like, the thing is, like, you get, like, 10 steps into this tunnel, and you're like, this is terrifying. I don't want to be in here. And, yeah.
That's
the story. Yeah, like, we pretty much just ended up coming late to this game.
All right, good stuff. We're going to cover our next commercial break. A couple words from our sponsors. You can see what they have to say. Welcome back to Young and Bummin' with Owen. We're going to give these up. We're not going to use those note cards anymore. We're just going to freestyle from here on out. Now, I there's some famous bums out in the world there, you know? And some of the most famous bums that have been on TV lately, I would say, are the workaholics guys. They live the life, the bum life. Like, if you're a bum, you dream to live that life. They do nothing, party, roll out of bed, go to a crap job, and make some money so they can just wake up and party the next day, you know?
Exactly.
Like, that's a good day in the life of me, in my world. How about you guys? Do you guys agree?
I totally agree.
Like, that's like living the dream.
Yeah.
Looking for a job, I'd take that.
Take that job? Working
absolutely.
At some, calling people, selling things?
Easy.
How about you, Liam? Would you take that job?
I would.
Are you too good for that
job?
Growing up in Little Silver.
Yeah, I'm too good for that job. No, I'd take that job in a heartbeat. I have no money.
You have no money?
I'm a kid. What do you expect?
Yeah, that's true. Now, there's another bum that I wanted to talk about today. MC Hammer.
Oh.
MC Hammer.
Yeah.
He was at one point rich, famous. Everyone knows him. And now he's got nothing.
He's nobody.
A nobody.
Yeah. That's it.
That's all you got to know from MC Hammer.
But he's still a good guy.
I'm sure he's a good guy.
He's fun to hang out with, too.
I mean, that's what I'm saying. He's probably a great guy to hang out with. But, like, he, like, kind of ruined. He just bummed it a little too hard. You got to know when to bum it and know when to not bum it.
Yeah.
And then we have our really famous bum. He's not famous to everyone out there in the world, but to us, he's the most famous. He taught us our bum ways.
Yeah.
His name is Caleb Darty, and he had bummed it all the way from New Jersey to California, where he still is out there right now to this day. And now that's saying something.
Yeah.
Like, Caleb Darty, he was with us when we were crawling in those tunnels. Caleb was with us for the great, infamous Blue Claws game.
Oh, yeah.
Like, do any of you guys want to tell the story about the Blue Claws game?
I think
Holly should tell, because Holly was sober. We don't really remember it.
I don't.
No.
Cody was driving.
No. Caleb was
false.
Driving.
Caleb was
driving.
You just
false.
I'm not good at stories. So we were at my house trying to get something to put together to make the Blue Claws game a little better. So we just took a little of everything we could find in the cabinet, popsicles.
We did put
adult
some ice pops in there.
Beverages, anything
that's
we found.
That's why it was brown.
It was like a 32-ounce Gatorade bottle, you know? It was like, you know, that's a lot.
On the
for
way to
just
like Blue Claws family night.
Yeah.
We watched Jake Kaler play.
Yeah, no, Irish. It was
Ryan Kaler's play.
It was like
and it
family.
It happened to be Celt Day, too, yeah.
Yeah. This was unbeknownst to us, you know?
Yeah, we didn't know that.
So Owen grabbed a bicycle helmet just in case on the way.
Just in
to
case.
Wear.
You never know when someone might knock your noggin.
Mm-hmm.
The drive went all right.
Except for
Caleb got to try to get the
pulled
cop
over,
comes.
But wouldn't pull him over. Caleb just got nervous and kept driving.
Yeah. I think he had just gotten his license.
Yeah. That was a little scary, but
that was
got through
scary.
That part.
I don't like dealing with the police.
We made it there. I think Owen might have got kicked out.
No, I didn't get kicked out.
Lost the helmet.
Nah, me and Cody were walking.
Lost the helmet.
Me and Cody were walking around making laps at the Blue Claws game around the field, just talk, and Cody's talking, everyone has a kilt on, going up to him, yo, I love your kilt, I love your kilt. People don't have a kilt, he's going, get out of here, you don't have a kilt on, get out of here. And Eric's dad, Holly's dad is at the Blue Claws game, calls Holly, he's like, you gotta find your friends, Owen and Cody, they're causing trouble, and they're gonna get kicked out. I heard someone talking to the cops about him. So Holly comes and finds us, like a good friend that he is, tells us we need to leave. We get out of there, no trouble incurred, which is great. I'm always getting in trouble,
mm-hmm.
So I'm happy to not get in trouble for once. Which that was a good time. It was an event.
Yeah, no
eventful
regrets.
Blue Claws game.
No regrets.
No regrets at all. No trouble. Good time.
Mm-hmm.
That was fun. Now, like, what else? What else do you guys like? What else do you guys do when you're bumming it? Like, you said you sleep. You said like
sleeping is a big majority of being a bum.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you guys
gotta
bathe?
Get like, huh?
Do you guys bathe?
Yeah.
I'm gonna take this as a no.
Yeah, it's an occasional kind of thing. You gotta save water, you know.
Like after you go to the beach and you use those free showers, that's
exactly.
Okay. But
exactly,
like, what about taking a real shower at someone's house?
It's not as often.
Not as often. Is it like? And is there like rules to you shower at your own house, or you have to shower somewhere else?
No, I'm usually more comfortable showering in my shower.
In your shower?
Yeah.
You like your shower a lot?
Yeah, I grew up in it, you know?
I know, I've been in your house. Is your shower still falling through the ceiling?
Yes.
It is?
Yes.
So any moment right now, just...
Any moment, I'm going to be in my grandma's room butt naked.
I'm sure Grandma Ruthie will appreciate that.
Yeah, absolutely.
She's a good lady.
Whoa.
Grandma Ruthie. Oh my God. Speaking of Grandma Ruthie, do you remember when Rob Corsi was in your house?
Yeah, you remember when... She kicked Tibor out.
For punching Caleb in the face.
Yeah.
We actually just did a segment earlier about video games.
We did?
No, not you guys, but the other people did.
Okay.
And all I could think about was when that we were system linking Xbox.
Yeah.
And,
that was back in the day. Yeah, that was the thing to do.
Xbox,
that was awesome.
Yeah, no live. We're gangster.
Yeah.
System linking Xbox.
Like a
straight
six-inch TV.
You get a kill. And Tibor runs out and punches our other friend, our friend Caleb, the ultimate bum in the face, because he killed him in the game. It was like, and then Cody's grandma comes and starts wailing him with this rolled up newspaper and kicks him out. It was a good old time for being like your age.
Yeah.
Oh, and one more thing I want to talk about. Recess. I hear that you don't have recess anymore.
Yeah.
You're in sixth grade. I had recess up until eighth grade.
Well, you have
that
recess anymore?
They don't have recess at Markham anymore.
What?
Yes, we do not have
recess
anymore.
How are they going to battle obesity in America?
Dude, they're just not doing
it anymore.
They can't be trying.
Yeah.
Like, Americans are fat, but we're taking away recess from these kids.
Also, gym is a joke, pretty much. Like,
Yeah.
Yeah, you play a game where you run around, you pull like a flag off somebody, and you're like, hey, you're in, ha ha.
Yeah. And there's a lack of dodgeball, you know?
Yes,
no
exactly.
Dodgeball.
No
that's
dodgeball.
Retarded.
That's been a rule since,
I love dodgeball.
Yeah.
Ever.
Dude, the trick in dodgeball, you got to run up and lob the ball up in the air, and they go to catch it and take them out.
Yeah.
Break their nose.
I was on an intramural dodgeball team.
Intramural dodgeball team?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Actually, we play a different type of dodgeball. Sorry to cut you off.
No, it's fine. I want
to
hear.
We play a different type of dodgeball.
I don't care about that anymore. We're going to cut this out today and we're going to be done for right now. And
it's a wrap?
It's a wrap, dude. We're going to call. We're calling this. We're going to have drinks later. It'll be a good time.
It's good
I'm so
night.
Happy you guys are on
Absolutely.
The TV show. Thanks.
Myself a round of applause.
It's been fun.